Hello, this is Mocha Product Manager Martin Brennand with an overview of what's new in Mocha Pro 2022.5. This new point release is a free update for all customers with an active support plan or subscription. And for those veteran users out there, keep watching because there's a feature at the end of this video that is going to blow your mind. Figuratively. The lens module has some helpful improvements to make calibrations much easier. You can now choose to create open splines directly in the lens view instead of relying on automatic line detection. This is as simple as checking Use Splines, then drawing splines that follow lens distorted edges in the scene. When in this mode, your splines will automatically be set to open splines. Then, you can choose your calibration type and click Calibrate. This technique is especially useful if the shot you're trying to calibrate doesn't have a lot of practical reference edges in the scene. Additionally, there is now the ability to import and reuse Mocha lens data. Once you've calibrated a scene, you can export the information via Export Lens Data, then import the saved calibration settings into the project. We all know Mocha is an amazing planar tracker, but what happens when you get a blurry, low detail, or flickery shot? Now the tracking module includes the pre-processing panel, which provides several non-destructive settings to tweak how the footage looks before tracking. You can adjust blur, sharpen, contrast, gamma, and denoise parameters to reduce problem areas or punch up detail in your source clip. There is also the remove flicker option to help reduce stuttering from sources such as fluorescent lighting. Each adjustment can be previewed and applies to all or individual layers depending on your preference. For those that just want to see better, we've also added a gamma field to the brightness view in view controls, making it easier to find edges or detail when working on your shot. Ultimately, when working with tracking, we're often using the surface tool, our trusty blue rectangle that represents the planar tracking data in the project. In this release, we've added a right-click menu to the surface to make it easy to apply adjustments. First, we have a set ratio submenu to quickly apply commonly used ratio settings. These ratios are projected to the distorted surface, so you don't have to do too much additional adjustment. Source applies the current ratio that the tracked footage uses. Insert applies the pixel ratio from the insert clip. You then have the common ratios of typical screens, like 16:9, 4:3, and 2:1. Finally, you can set a custom ratio, which allows you to enter your own values. Below Set Ratio is Align, which mirrors the Align Surface tool, pushing the surface to the full dimensions of the source clip. Hide, which hides the surface, and Reset, which resets the surface back to a squared off rectangle inside the layer boundaries. Finally, there's the option to quickly hide the insert clip if one exists in the surface. These tools make the general surface workflow much quicker to use instead of having to endlessly tweak corners or buttons to find the right placement. We've also added a menagerie of other smaller features to make your Mocha life easier. You can now click inside the frame rate dropdown list to create your own custom frame rate rather than having to stick to the set values. The Mocha plugin GUI will now always come to the foreground when you switch back to your host to avoid having to hunt for the window when it's still open. We've included Apple M1 support for video clip import and ProRes export, and multiple tweaks and fixes for 360 VR workflows. All these are included with Mocha Pro 2022.5, along with many defect fixes and performance improvements. And finally, a feature that new and veteran users alike have been asking about for a long, long time. Mocha has mouse wheel scroll support for zooming the viewer.
Yeah!
This is also adjustable in preferences, so you can define how you would like the viewer zoom and timeline scrolling to be set up. Again, this important update, along with the rest of the Mocha Pro 2022.5 features you've seen today, is free for all customers on valid support contracts or active subscription plans. If you have any questions, please feel free to add them in the comments or contact us over on the forums at borisfx.com.